Hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here, and today I'm going to be discussing the importance of properly researching and doing a little shopping before committing to an auto service center. In my case, it had to do with a crack I had developed in the windshield of my 2007 Kia Rio 4-door, and my first instinct was to turn to the large names, the big names in auto repair, auto glass repair and replacement. In Quebec, where I live, that is to say, Lebeau, VitroPlus, Docteur, Pare-Brise, puis Duro. Those companies. So what I did was, I first turned to those companies, I called those companies, and I had received quotes. However, I decided, you know what? Maybe I could do better. So what I then did was I turned to the YellowPages website, and I did a search. I looked for Pare-Brise, which is windshield in French, and I listed the various companies within a 20-kilometer radius of where I live, and in an order from shortest distance from my house to longest distance from my house. I then began to call every company and ask the same question. How much would it cost to replace the windshield on my 2007 Kia Rio 4-door? And this is what I found. There are substantial savings to be had if you do a bit of research. This is especially the case if you believe that the large big-name companies will give you the best price for your windshield repair, which is simply not the case, which is what I found out. The first company I contacted, now it's important to note that these prices that I'm quoting here are prices that were obtained in June of 2012. They shouldn't be used as a reference as the market changes, the cost of these components can go up or go down. This is just to illustrate how important it is to do research before committing. So the big names, Lebeau, they quoted me at $724.15 to replace my windshield. This not only represents the highest price of all the big names, but it quite simply put represents the highest price of all the names. Now, given the marketing power, the advertising and media power of Lebeau, their presence, they're practically everywhere. That alone would cause, I assume, many people to, you know, go to one place, get one quote, and figure, okay, well, that's the going rate, that's the market rate, and might as well go with that. When the couldn't be further from the truth. Let me illustrate. Another big name, VitroPlus. They quoted me $550 plus tax. Already, we're saving close to $200 from Lebeau, and these are amongst the big guys. Pare-Brise International, this is a small company, $300 plus tax. Now look at this. We went from $724 from a big name, Lebeau, to $300 from a small name, Pare-Brise International. Moving on, Docteur du Pare-Brise, another big name, $375. Of the big name companies, Docteur du Pare-Brise gave the best rate. Now I consider that there are four big name companies in the auto glass industry here in Quebec. So you keep that in mind, and Docteur du Pare-Brise gave the best rate of those companies. Of course, the smaller name companies gave overall better rates, of course. Discount, Vitres D'autos, $220, which is exceptional. This, as far as I'm concerned, was the best price I obtained. I obtained a bit less elsewhere, but for my troubles, Discount Vitres D'autos gave me the best price as far as I'm concerned. Pare-Brise.ca gave me $250 as a quote. Vitres D'autos Abuti-Bourguin gave me $340. Now this is interesting. They quoted me first at $340. They then asked me, now, which illustrates that there's always a flexibility, there's always room to negotiate. I wasn't in the market to negotiate. My goal out of this wasn't to negotiate, it was just to find the best offer right off the dot. But Vitres D'autos Abuti-Bourguin asked me, right after giving me the quoted price, they asked me if I had done some shopping and if I had found any better offers. Of course, I did. I quoted them the discount VitroPlus price, and at which point they re-quoted at $215, which illustrates that there is a certain flexibility. Lebeau Vitres quoted me $275. Now, this is interesting. $275 plus tax, plus the moulure. What the moulure is, it's the lining, I guess you could say. The rubber lining that... the molding. There you go, that's the term. The molding that goes around your windshield. Some companies will include this at no extra cost. Some companies will charge for it. And as you could see, molding can actually bring that price up considerably when a company is charging for it. These guys were $275 plus $40 for the molding. Aramis did $280. Jax did $270.19. Pare-Brise 545 did $270. Now this is interesting. Plus $20 for a moulure jabber. What that means is it's, think of a generic molding, just a molding made by a company that makes many moldings, not an original equipment manufacturer product. Whereas to get the original molding from, I assume it's, I want to say Kia, but I doubt it's Kia, just perhaps from the, excuse me, from the factory that supplies Kia with molding, that would double the price on the molding. $40 for the molding. Duro, the other big name, $460. Certainly not advantageous in the least. Lehu gave me $385 plus. The plus indicates plus tax. By the way, I assume that all these prices listed are plus tax. I don't think any of them were tax included. Auto Distinction, $280 plus tax. Le Roi du Pare-Brise, $255 plus tax. Action Mobile, $360 plus $46 for the molding. What follows this are listings I obtained through Kijiji. Now, these listings were obtained in the same method that I obtained listings from the Yellow Pages. That is to say, in the search criteria, I entered the word pare-brise, which is windshield in French, and I listed in order from distance from my house, from my home address, with the closest companies listed first and the farthest companies listed last. So, Vente remplacement VitroPlus, they charge me $280, or they would have. Whoops, starting to mess up my file. Pare-brise, contactez-nous, $240. Installation Pare-brise, $320. And Pare-brise neuf cinq pièces et plus, he was going to give me $225, which is certainly advantageous considering its taxes included. Also, with a bill and guaranteed for life for water infiltration. And it's also installed at the place that you wish without cost in the Montreal area. I was outside of the Montreal area, but he gave me an offer and offered me the quoted price even despite that I was outside the Montreal area. So there you go. What this illustrates is the importance of doing a little bit of shopping, doing a little bit of research before committing to any one particular company, and especially not relying on simply the big names as the reference for price. It's not like produce and groceries where you go to a big name like Walmart or Maxi and all of a sudden you're getting a better price than if you went to an independent grocer or a corner store. Here, smaller guys will often give a much better price. Excuse me. Now, the other thing to mention, some people may say, well, I don't care what the cost is. Simply put, I'm insured, so it doesn't matter. I'm paying insurance. I want my insurance to be worth something. I can tell you right now, this is an error. You should not do this. The reason for that is because this price, $724.15. Let's say you have no deductible. You have an insurance where your deductible for glass is covered. You don't have to pay anything. Your insurance will pay $724.15. Great. Okay, fine. Well, are you aware that that price, that reclamation, that's the word in English, stays with you for, on average, 6 years. Some companies even look back as far as 10 years. Now, you're thinking, well, what do I care if they see that I made a reclamation? Well, what that means is that will directly affect what your insurance premiums, your insurance costs are for the next 6 to 10 years. It essentially means that your insurance costs will be higher than if there was no reclamation. Now, this is especially worth noting for those who think, oh, well, it doesn't matter, my price never changes, I stay with the same insurer, I'm happy with that, I have nothing to worry about. Remember the time frame we're talking about here, 6 to 10 years. Think to yourself, is it likely that you are going to change vehicles in the next 6, very possible, to 10 very likely years? And the answer is yes. Now, even if you stay with the same insurer, what's going to happen is you're going to need a new contract because it's a different car. A new contract means a new quoted price, a new quoted cost for the insurance, and that new quoted cost will be based on precedents, including prior reclamations. Another thing to keep in mind is the deductible. If you have to pay a deductible, if your insurance agreement stipulates that you have a deductible to pay. Now, what a deductible is an amount of money that you first have to assume for the cost of a reparation before the insurer assumes the rest of the cost. So, take for example my case. My insurance agreement is that I assume the first $250 of glass damage before the insurance pays. If I have to assume $250 and I found a company that will do the replacement for $220, well, at this point it doesn't make sense. Not only would I still be paying out of my pocket, but the insurance would assume none of the cost. Plus, there would be that record of windshield repair on my my file. So, there's no advantage to going through your insurance. It just doesn't make sense. Even if you found a company that, once again, Lebeau, I'm picking on Lebeau, well, they're the highest, they deserve to be picked on. $724.15. If I were to pay the $250 deductible out of my pocket, and the insurer assures the rest, covers the rest, well, now I have that reclamation for, $400 and something dollars, and that remains on my record for 6 to 10 years, it doesn't make sense. It's way easier to just, go to the $220 place, pay it out of pocket, and not break my head over it. And there you go. That's what I'm trying to illustrate here. That's the lesson. It makes sense to do research. Doing research is in your best interest.